Hello, this is David, Principal Engineer at Dell, and today I'll be covering performing an authoritative sync of SYSVOL using the File Replication Service, or FRS. As mentioned in the non-authoritative video, FRS has been deprecated for a while now, but it is still around, and it does still break. In an authoritative sync, you tell a domain controller to initialize FRS using its copy of the SYSVOL data rather than copying it from another domain controller, as in a non-authoritative sync. We're back in our 2DC domain here, and as you can see, we're on DC2. And if we run net share here, we'll see that there's no SYSVOL or netlog on share indicated in the output. And this is common if a domain controller is promoted after FRS has broken on another domain controller. It will never replicate SYSVOL, and therefore it won't create the shares. If we look in the event viewer on this one, we'll see an event saying file replication service is having trouble enabling replication from DC1 to DC2 for the SysVol content. And often when you see this error on a domain controller, it means the real problem is on its replication partner, in this case DC1. So let's take a look at DC1. If we run net share here, we see it does have a net log on in SysVol share. So that part's working okay. But if we check the event viewer, we see this error here. The file replication service is in an error state. Now, just like in the other video, this is an artificially created error. The error message you get may be different, although in this case, FRS really is broken. I just manually broke it. So you may see other events here indicating it's not working. Now we go to group policy management and we can see there are 5 GPOs in this domain. And if we go into the SysVol folder in File Explorer, we see we do have 5 GUID folders corresponding to those GPOs. As we did before, we could go through and look at the properties of each GPO and confirm that those GUIDs match the GUIDs in their settings tab, but there's no need to do that this time. Just trust me, they do match. So what we'll need to do here, because the problem is on DC1 and DC1 actually does have the GPOs, we will need to perform an authoritative sync. First, we'll need to stop the file replication service before we make any changes. And it takes a few seconds to stop. Next, we go into registry, and once again, we're at HK local machine, system, current control set, services, NtFrs, parameters, backup restore, process at startup. And we're looking at that burr flags dword value again. If we modify this to perform an authoritative sync, we'll set it to D4 hex instead of D2 for non-authoritative. And that corresponds to 212 decimal. Once we do that, we start the file replication service. Wait for it to start. And if we go back and refresh the registry, we'll see that burr flags has gone back to 0, which means it has done something. Now, if we go to event viewer, we can see that there are new events in the FRS event log. So we will refresh, drag this down so you can see more. And go back to our last error. That was the event that was there before. Just scroll through these one by one. We can see the service is stopping, has stopped, is starting, deprecated. As I mentioned, we already knew that. And then we'll see that same warning about a write cache, which we can ignore. And then we get to this one, file replication service is scanning the data in the system volume, can't become a domain controller until that's complete. Means we're getting there. Next event, successfully added the computer to the replica set. Then successfully added connections to the replica set, and since we only have 2 domain controllers, inbound and outbound connections go to DC2 since this is DC1. And finally, we see event 13516, which is our all good event. File replication service is no longer preventing the computer from becoming a domain controller. Run net share again, and we see nothing's changed here. It had a SysVol and netlog on share to begin with, and it still does. If we go into the policies folder in File Explorer, we see nothing has changed there either. Those same 5 GUID folders are still there, and that's as expected. If we switch over to DC2, We see now its FRS event log has some new events. So we go and refresh that log. And the 13508 event was our last warning. 13509, I've never been sure why this is a warning, because this is actually a good event. As you can see, it says it's enabled replication after repeated retries. So that means something's working now that wasn't working before. So I'm not sure why that's classified as a warning. But then we see we have the 13516 info event here too, saying that FRS is no longer preventing it from being a DC. So if we run netshare again, now we see we have sysvol and netlog on shares. And if we go into the sysvol folder in File Explorer and refresh policies, we see we do now have the same five GUIDs here that we had on DC1. This means that the authoritative sync on DC1 enabled DC2 to replicate sysvol content as we intended. You may find in some cases that you need to perform a non-authoritative sync on your other domain controllers after you perform an authoritative sync on one of them, but we didn't have to do that this time. Once again, I'm David, principal engineer at Dell, and thank you for watching.